The death of imagination on Roblox. Roblox's tagline is powering imagination, but over the past 5 years, it's becoming more and more apparent that this tagline means nothing. Today, we'll be discussing why modern Roblox is essentially now creatively bankrupt. Without further ado, don't forget to like, subscribe, and let's get straight into this discussion. With Roblox straying further away from its model of making games that power imagination into something like making games with the sole use of exploiting children's dopamine levels for revenue, we can see that most developers see creative ideas and games as a risk rather than something that can be rewarded on the platform, which they are low-key right to think that way. Roblox itself is an imitation of almost every popular media form. Nowadays on Roblox, all you see now is attempts of developers to try to copy the latest trends into a game. It's okay to take inspiration from something, but blatantly copying is only standing to hurt the platform further. Exhibit A, the Blox Streets effect. As we know already, Blox Streets is the biggest modern Roblox game right now, and there is no doubt about that. The game was released back in 2019, and it only took a few months in 2020 for the game to steadily pick up pace and easily become the biggest Roblox game by far. Inspired by the One Piece series, Blox Streets took the formula from past One Piece games like Steve's One Piece, One Piece Legendary, One Piece Golden Age, and so many classic One Piece games on the platform and made it to something more streamlined with the main focus of adding more to keep the players playing for as long as possible. Yes, the game might not be the best in the world, but it simply does what Roblox wants, creating a simplified experience that keeps the player's attention with the hopes of getting them to splurge cash on predatory monetization models, just like how free mobile games like Dokken Battle do this as well. With Blox Streets, they made it to where they made the grind obscenely long and tedious. They give you a 2x XP game pass to help with that, but they are so cheap that they know people will eventually buy into it to skip the hard progression. They also give you the option to bypass the food spin dealer and just outright let you buy the best power-ups in the game permanently for thousands of Robux. The perfect format of giving a solution to an inconvenience that they themselves created on purpose. Now let's look at the creative games that Blox Streets inspired other devs to make. King's Legacy. Oh, you start on an island with the same bandit to boss quest layout, then move on. A One Piece game. You start on an island, but this time you can buy packs for whatever power up you want to avoid grinding for anything in the game. It follows the same format as King's Legacy and Blox Streets. Haze piece. Same ordeal, with the pack even giving you gear 4th and other rewards off spawn to give you an immediate advantage over people who don't pay. This follows the instant gratification Roblox suggests the developers do to monetize their games. You see where I'm going with this? Each One Piece game that has come out after Blox Streets, excluding a very rare few, has followed the same monetization models, gameplay loop, and design. It has slowly made its way into other anime RPGs as well, leading us into a massive epidemic of games that play and feel the exact same no matter what stolen anime IP is attached to it. I grew up playing games like Final Stand, Shinobi Life, Steve's One Piece, all games that at the time innovated and pushed the anime community further. The anime community has never fully been its own thing, and we have always seen copies throughout it, but it seems like there's less and less pioneers popping up nowadays. The Blox Streets effect is just one example. Let's move on to another genre that has seemingly went against that also famous tagline. Exhibit B, the Great Simulator Infestation. The absolute worst cesspool that has seemingly gotten worse with time is simulators. I want to bring you an example of this. The one game that has seen so many copies is Anime Fighter Simulator. The game that got super popular around 1 to 2 years ago, where you would go through different worlds with your favorite anime characters and watch them beat up a non-moving NPC while your dopamine levels rise to an incomprehensible level. This game has been copied several times. We have games like Anime Warriors 2, and as you can imagine, it's the exact same game as Anime Fighter Simulator, but basically worse and had way more pay-to-win aspects, which led to people leaving that game and going back to Anime Fighter Simulator, which is the reason why it now receives no more updates and is now a dead game. They did attempt to copy Anime Fighter Simulator the first time with Anime Warriors 1, but just as the second, it is now dead and forgotten. Next is Anime Champion Simulator, which is a game created by the original creators of Anime Fighter Simulator, and a YouTuber by the name of Old Trade Mark used to also play Anime Fighter Simulator on his channel. Essentially, Anime Champions is the exact same game as Anime Fighter Simulator, but one thing I can say about this game is that it's more free to play than most simulators. What I mean by this is you can buy basically every game pass in the game with gems. Granted, it is very grindy to do so, and it's just a lot easier to buy, but still, this is a cool option that they give players. And look what happens when a developer finally considers what the player might like. The copy actually can beat the original in this case, as Anime Champions is outright destroying Anime Fighter Simulator and has single-handedly killed the game due to its free-to-play features. But beyond just the Roblox anime simulators, simulators in general are usually just copies of the same idea, just oversaturated to the extreme, and the idea of one is to generate revenue through dopamine-inducing monetization tactics. Even though technically simulators are as predatory as they come, some people genuinely enjoy simulators, and that's okay. They just aren't what I'd consider to be a proper video game, since you aren't actually playing for the majority of your time on said genre. Exhibit C, the Strongest Battlegrounds Offspring. The Strongest as Battlegrounds is a really popular anime arena fighting game, now the difference between something like this game and something like ABA is the fact that the strongest Battlegrounds has a really low skill ceiling. But the reason for this game's success is the very flashy effects on the actual skills in the game. Although you are playing on a pretty basic and bland base plate, nothing really matters when you are destroying your opponent over and over with cool looking super attacks, and it gives the player a rush I don't think a lot of other Battlegrounds games can actually provide the player. This game, for the most part, is also free to play. Like, yes, there's early access characters, but most of the time they aren't finished yet, so aren't actually viable against the characters who are actually finished in the game. A very simplistic formula that again has been copied by uncreative developers. Just to name a few, we have Heroes Battlegrounds, Sorcerer Battlegrounds, Sea Battlegrounds, and countless others who have taken the strongest Battlegrounds formula and copied it into different stolen anime IPs, just like what is happening with the anime RPGs. Thing is, all copies in this part of the community don't come close to the strongest Battlegrounds because it has the most features, the smoothest combat system available out of the bunch. So in reality, all these devs are just creating more games that are limited by the fact that they won't go beyond the original unless someone makes a Battlegrounds game that takes a huge leap of improvements, but even then, it still might not be able to beat the strongest Battlegrounds. These games are huge on TikTok and YouTube due to how flashy the moves are, and therefore there's a constant publicity stream with these games, as well as the strongest Battlegrounds constantly trending on all social media platforms. These games probably will die out in the next coming year or so, or maybe they'll live out for the next 5 if they can evolve, but only time will tell. Exhibit D, other game genres suffer too. Now moving away from just anime games is this bit right here. The reality is that the entire platform has been suffering from this epidemic since forever really. It's only gotten worse just recently with the popularity of the websites shifting upwards and the focus of creativity turning into the focus on money. Horror games, for example, suffer from the copy and paste experience games that are stemmed from one game. And these games have you doing menial tasks like a 9-to-5 job, and then you investigate about a killer, and then an event happens which triggers you to find the killer, and then you run from said killer, and then you have a final choice between A or B, which are usually good or bad endings, but both are pretty predictable as to which one is going to be which. Or even games that are now trying to copy Blade Ball directly with a game called Anime Ball recently that just got a few thousand players, which will most likely lead to more Blade Ball copies. Even Blade Ball itself was a copy. Or better yet, those countless copy and paste simulator tower defense games like the super brain rotting skibbity toilet games. Like, even as a kid, I would have thought this was a terrible game due to just how cringe and boring it is. And these games are seemingly being copy and pasted every day and gaining thousands of players and success. Do you understand how deadly this is to the creativity of the platform? Exhibit E, how this will indefinitely never change. Roblox will most likely not be remembered as a platform that once had innovative creative games that were made by people just like me and you. Kids were and have always been a focal point of Roblox, and even with them trying to expand out, it's clear that they have no idea what they are doing. Why is it that when Roblox thinks of anyone above the age of 17, they think, oh, let's advertise online dating bars where you can literally get drunk and roleplay yourself doing something you can't even do in the real world yet? Due to Roblox's naivety, 17 plus games will always be throwaway trash until a developer feels like their game can still do well with the majority of the platform being under 17. Let's face it, Roblox loves the copy and paste game and don't enforce any rules saying you can't copy and paste games and get taken down for it. Due to this, it has led to people just simply not caring about what they make anymore. Whatever makes Roblox the most money will always be featured on the front page, and people will continue to copy that to try to get on the front page, while games that take weeks and months and are unique will continuously get thrown in the dirt. I just don't see this changing anytime soon unless Roblox changes their policy and stand by their tagline, powering imagination. If you guys enjoyed this video and you would like to see more content like this one, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.